Hello everyone, today I want to talk about the MJ boss fight from Marvel's Spider-Man 2 Electric Boogaloo, the worst boss fight in gaming history.
Harry, we are not Harry. We are...
What is going on?
What the fuck is this?
Both business these. Both business these.
Having oral sex with my mouth, licking his balls.
No matter how impossible it seems, and lifting is the only way. The only way.
Seeing these videos that surface, it's kind of alarming, man. And I can't play the whole video because I don't think YouTube will let me. But I'm going to show you the frame, and then I'm going to show you the video comeback live after the act happened. And just listen to the sound of it. Let's check it out.
Now, before you few console pigs out there get all gaga goo goo about this, I don't mean technically. You know, to be honest, I haven't even played the game. What I'm talking about is, you know, something more conceptually, philosophically, even spiritually, if you want to go that far with it. The MJ boss fight is even worse than the Ellie boss fight in The Last of Us Part 2. Because at least with The Last of Us Part 2, besides it being kind of cool to see Ellie in action, you know, being on the other side of that, because she's a little beast in that game, even though it actually betrays the player... You know, Last of Us Part 2 betrays the player, but betrays what we all expected from the first game. It's not just about subverting expectations. It's really a betrayal of, like, the connection that we have with these characters. But it doesn't actually betray what they wanted to do in the story. If their mission was to show, you know, two sides of a story, fine. From Abby's point of view, Ellie is the boss. But with MJ shouldn't even be in this game. And MJ's not the focus of Spider-Man, and she's clearly not the largest interest of Spider-Man fans. We don't play Spider-Man to play as MJ. This was already established in the first game, after we got all those stupid stealth sections. Even though the game itself was fun to play, people were like, look, these stealth sections are absurd. You have to stop this. Brian Entity, one of the creative directors, literally says, it's acknowledged, nobody really liked the MJ missions. And they said to take them out for the sequel. They decided that no, we're going to keep those in. And we're going to make her more important to the story. So you're at a point now where this boss fight epitomizes everything wrong with this entire, I don't know, woke culture. It's truly one of the main things that makes Spider-Man 2 like the death of AAA gaming. Like after this, there's really no, there's not much further down AAA studios can go. And it sets a bad precedent for the kind of things that we're obviously going to get from these companies going forward. You know, they're hiring too many women who don't respect or care about this stuff. The MJ boss fight isn't about Spider-Man overcoming an enemy. It's about the writers, these women who don't understand or care about this stuff, telling fans that they're wrong not to respect and want MJ in the game. It's literally, this woman, who's just a side character, she's just a supporting character, she's just the love interest. That's all she is. It's these writers resenting the fact that the central character of a male-dominated hobby, comic books, the central character is more important than the supporting character. And the supporting character is a woman. So they resent the fact that the woman is not as important, that she's just the love interest. That in a male hobby, in video games, where people want to play as Peter Parker, Spider-Man. This boss fight is there to tell you you're wrong not to care about MJ. And that Peter is, other people have talked about this, where they say, it sounds like MJ is the mouthpiece for the female writers who are angry at an ex-boyfriend or something. But really what it is, they treat Peter as if Peter is the fan. They don't treat Peter as who the fans look up to.
We are
MJ jumping in front of Peter to protect him from Venom is like, I know they're trying to show her as this amazing, capable hero, but it undermines Peter because he's standing there looking like an idiot. Like, he's the one with the super reflexes. Even if his Spidey sense doesn't work on Venom, he still sees there's a threat. And as soon as MJ got close to him, knowing that Venom is a threat, he should have grabbed her and hopped out of there. But no, he's standing there looking like an idiot when she jumps in front of the BBC. It's so stupid. And everything, all the choices they made, none of them were about making Peter look good. It was always about making MJ or Miles better. And I just can't get over how Sony let Insomniac spend $300 and something million on this game, and they made MJ the hero, and they made her look the way that they did.
There's only one job you care about. Spider-Man!
That's not fair! People need me! You know that!
What would the city do without Spider-Man? Look how it's doing with you!
I can still fix this! I always do! We always do!
What does he mean, we? She doesn't do shit, she's just MJ. The name of the game is Spider-Man. Spider-Man's the one who has the history of fighting Juggernaut, or the Blob, or Green Goblin, Doc Ock. He's the one with the Rogues Gallery and stuff. Not MJ. MJ is the love interest. Like, why is everything built up around her? I know why, but if you're making this game and you're writing this story and you're letting women write it, you need to step back and realize who's the audience for this stuff. Like, who's going to play this game and why people care about superhero comics and comic books in general. They're not even thinking about that. She's talking about her dreams while she's denigrating Spider-Man for being a superhero. That's risking his life to save people. You know, these activists, they lack so much self-awareness. It's being Spider-Man is not a career. It's not like this exciting, sexy career. It's his life's work. It's what he does to help people. They keep thinking about power fantasies, but they're the ones with the power fantasies. They're the ones with the stupid self-inserts. Like, for them, the game is about how MJ hasn't been seen and heard enough, not Spider-Man saving the day.
Remember your book? You said you want to help people!
Nobody read it!
These blue-haired cancel pigs know their stuff is garbage, and they know it doesn't sell. I mean, it's obvious. That's why they have to take our shit. Then they get mad when people say, look, this is our shit. If you want to do that shit with your junk, you do it with your junk. And their excuse is, well, it doesn't sell. Well, it doesn't sell, it doesn't sell. That means people don't want it. You don't get to hijack other people's property to make yourself feel good. You failed. Move on.
Nobody cares! That's not true! If I helped one person, it was worth it!
And that's why they double and triple down, because they don't care if the property makes money or not. They're just trying to spread their agenda. If there's just one deaf, mute black girl out there who's spray tagging her city with cringe BIPOC affirmations and slogans, even if she doesn't play the game or won't even give two shits about the game, at least she can be seen. Who cares if we're spending $300 million on this? At least there's a woman, average to ugly, out there who's always dreamed of being the love interest of an iconic superhero. At least people can look at her and say, wow, Peter Parker dated a woman who looks like that. Maybe I want to date someone who looks like that too.
Nobody
I read it! It helped me!
All I do is help you!
MJ,
my life is constantly interrupted by you!
Says the bitch who keeps dragging down these games by being in them way too much. Even when people say we don't want her here, they still shove her in here.
Looking for answers. Leave. Because you lost a job or can't pay a bill. All right. The pain. All right. Words I don't believe in for a man I despise. So you can be happy.
They made sure they got that line in there. You see that, right? Normally, when the action interrupts dialogue like that, especially in the middle of some kind of boss fight or something, that's it. You just move on. But these niggas really wanted to humiliate Peter on every level. So she had to say it. Kyle made this point where he talked about how the MJ boss fight has four phases. It's the number one major boss fight in the entire game. And it's because they really wanted to spew out all the stuff that they wanted to get off their chest about how much they hate Peter Parker for being straight and white. And the fans for wanting to play as a straight white superhero character. And it's so stupid because Peter shouldn't even be apologizing to MJ in this context. Yeah, it's the boss fight and she's been taken over by Venom. So people can do this thing where they try to defend it and say, well, she's not herself. But no, it enhances what she already feels. But even if that's the case, even if you say she's not herself, it makes it even worse that it just doesn't enhance what she feels. Because they're saying that Peter is apologizing to an evil entity for things that are not true. If what she's saying is not true and how she really feels, why does Peter feel like he needs to apologize for anything? Like, they're having two different conversations. It doesn't make sense, again, for him to be apologizing. He should be saying, this isn't like you, MJ. Why are you saying these things? He wouldn't even talk about, it's not fear. What I do helps, it matters. It'd be like, this is what I do. Like, you know this is what I do. How is this interfering with you? Why do you need to work for J. Jonah Jameson? If you don't want to work for J. Jonah Jameson, quit. That's not going to stop me from being Spider-Man. Why is that stopping you? Why is me being Spider-Man stopping you from doing anything? If it's a matter of, well, I can't be with someone who risks his life and I'm a cop's wife or a soldier's wife. Sure, fine. That would be one thing. But she's denigrating him, acting like because he's Spider-Man, it's hurting her from living her best life. And again, he's justifying and validating what she's saying by apologizing. And personally, if I was directing this, I would fire Yuri Lowenthal because he sounds so disgusting in the way he took, oh, please, we can do this together. It's awful. Like, you weren't paid to sound that humiliated. Now, come on, this is ridiculous. I'd be like, you would think somebody would have a come to Jesus moment and say, man, he really sounds terrible. This is not even making any sense. He's apologizing to, if we're supposed to believe that Venom is just taking her over and nothing she's saying is true, then we really, what are we doing here? Why does Peter need to sound like this? Shouldn't Peter just say, snap out of it, MJ. You know, don't let this thing take you over like this. You're saying things that don't even make any sense. This is nothing like you. I know you. This is not you, MJ. But no, he's, oh my God, please. Oh my God. I only thought about myself, not you.
I didn't realize. MJ, you can quit. I can figure something out.
I can't trust you. I can only rely on us.
No, I'm sorry, MJ. I was wrong. You don't have to trust me. But please, trust yourself.
Let me do what I have to do.
You're right. I've been selfish. I was so wrapped up in my own life, I never thought about yours. But let's handle this MJ's way.
What the fuck is Peter talking about? The game is called Spider-Man 2. What is this bitch even doing here? Like, what is this? I just looking at the background of different stuff, looking at the fact that Peter and his Aunt May, they lived in a neighborhood full of black people. They lived in an all-black neighborhood. They've been only white people in the neighborhood, apparently. And then here during this fight, you got police cars all over the place, but no actual police around. You could hear sirens in the background, but the cops actually never show up. Like, why did this game cost $300 million again?
Yeah, I think I'm okay.
You did it.
Wait. Not yet.
Watson, where are you with my apple fritters? I'm starving. And
Jonah? Kiss my ass.
Get out of here. What are you talking about, ass? What ass?
Last dance with Mary Jane. One more time to kill the pain. I feel summer creeping in. I'm tired of this town again.
Standing in her underwear, looking down from a hotel room.